OnePlus have just announced the 7T Pro. It's the best phone they've ever made, and so we're going to look at two things. First of all, what's new here, and second of all, if that is enough for it to take on arguably the greatest Android phone out there. So, the original 7 Pro, released in May, was a bulky but powerful phone with one of the best displays I've ever seen. The 7T Pro doesn't lose any of this bulk, but OnePlus has refined the design. The blue color, for starters, is now more obvious and closer to a sky blue, which I think is slightly more photogenic. The laser autofocus is now outside the camera module instead of inside, and the pop-up camera on the front is now a lot quieter than before. OnePlus has restructured the battery to facilitate even faster charging. You're looking at a full charge from empty in literally an hour, and the battery itself is now larger, too. The display hasn't changed, but as is tradition with OnePlus, each new phone comes with its own set of fancy new live wallpapers. More importantly though, a speed bump. Whilst the 7 Pro used the pretty fast Snapdragon 855 chip, the 7T Pro uses the new 855 Plus chip, and combined with all the other speed-focused features here, like the light software skin, the fast UFS 3 storage, and the Fanatic mode for focused gaming, this is the fastest feeling Android phone I've ever used. That said, there's actually no 12GB RAM option on the 7T Pro. Unusually. I imagine this is OnePlus trying to streamline the number of options to avoid confusion, but it is kind of strange that their original 7 Pro could have 50% more RAM than its successor. The camera has a couple of new tricks too. You've got a macro mode that lets you get super close to subjects, you've got a night mode that is now improved and can work with the ultrawide camera as well, plus hybrid stabilization that uses both optical image stabilization and electronic, and it is super impressive, actually better than what the iPhone 11 can do. I noticed skin tones are coming out more naturally, and the image is just generally a bit smoother than on the 7 Pro. The software is just doing more cleaning up of graininess, and that is not a bad thing. And speaking of software, the 7T Pro ships with OnePlus's shiny new Oxygen OS 10 skin. It's a fresh coat of paint with a couple of new features thrown in, like a new gesture system and a dedicated gaming space that lets you see all your games together and bundles all settings tailored to gaming. So that's pretty much what's new, and that leaves us with the question, OnePlus 7T Pro or Samsung Galaxy Note 10 Plus? Well, Samsung beats the 7T Pro in a lot of areas. OnePlus really wins in four, but they're four really important things. So before we pick a winner, let's start with Samsung's perks. For most people, the Note 10 Plus will be the more ergonomic phone. It is slimmer and lighter, and that's a pretty impressive feat considering its larger battery, 4,300 mAh versus 4,085 on the 7T Pro. Plus, they've also managed to fit that S Pen in, which at the very least is a nice option to have. Even if you don't use it a lot, it feels fantastic when you do, and the device's software integrates it in a really organic way. It doesn't feel like just another accessory. That said, flipping the phones around, and I prefer the matte finish on the back of the OnePlus. It's much better at resisting fingerprints, but it is a little slippier. Oh yeah, and the headphone jack is gone on both. The Galaxy Note 10 Plus also has the better camera system, generally. As I mentioned, OnePlus has made meaningful improvements on the 7T Pro, and that phone can zoom further with 3x zoom versus Samsung's 2x, whilst also being able to get closer with its new super macro mode. But largely speaking, I think most people prefer the video, photo, and the audio quality coming from the Samsung Galaxy Note 10 Plus. Samsung just captures a wider dynamic range, able to preserve details in both the bright and the dark areas. Plus, its ultra-wide camera is just wider. It makes for more dramatic shots. In low light, the battle becomes much closer, and there isn't really all that much in it. To reiterate, they are both good, and with an update coming imminently, OnePlus will also be able to match Samsung's super slow-mo 960 frames per second video, but I think most will prefer Samsung's camera in general. Now, the Galaxy also has a whole load of, I guess you could call them quality of life advantages. The Note 10 Plus has a lot of love given to haptics. The phone has an improved vibration motor, which is one of those things that flies completely under the radar on a spec sheet, but makes the day-to-day experience feel tighter and more satisfying. Samsung has a micro SD card slot, so you can expand its storage, an IP rating for peace of mind when it comes to water and dust, plus wireless charging and being able to wirelessly reverse charge your friend's phone. Its dual speaker setup also makes for more audible details. You'll be listening to music and you can hear the finer background instrumentals more than you can with OnePlus. Depending on what kind of user you are, these are going to be anything from little bonuses to actually quite a big deal. Even security is a little more sophisticated on the Galaxy. It's equipped with an ultrasonic fingerprint scanner, which is harder to fool and requires less pressure to activate. OnePlus, because OnePlus has now a pop-up front camera, its face unlocking is a little slower than the Note's, whose front camera is ready to go at all times. Furthermore, even charging speeds, an advantage OnePlus has had for generations, Samsung has more or less caught up with. Even though the 7T Pro charges at a higher wattage and uses revamped Warp Charge 30 T-Tech, in my testing, for a full charge, the result is almost identical. But OnePlus does charge a bit faster in the first 20 minutes from empty. Displays are both good, like really, really good. You're looking at two similarly bright Quad HD Plus AMOLED panels, but there are some differences. You can probably see that Samsung's display curve is sharper, and because Samsung's display has been built to automatically filter out high-energy blue light, the result is that OnePlus has cleaner whites. And unlike the Note, which has a small cutout at the top for the camera, it is all screen, and this brings me onto OnePlus's advantages, the first of four being its refresh rate. Like the 7 Pro before it, the 7T Pro uses a 90Hz panel, meaning that its display refreshes 1.5 times faster than Samsung's. It is a big change, and if you haven't seen a 90Hz display in person before, it feels kind of like jumping from a family car straight into the seat of a sports car, or at least what I imagine that would feel like. Everything is instantly more responsive and fluid, and that brings me onto the second big perk of the OnePlus. Speed. It is not just a faster feeling phone, it is also more powerful under the hood. The OnePlus uses Qualcomm's latest Snapdragon 855 Plus chip, which you could expect to be about 10% faster in most demanding applications, but there is a catch. Whilst both devices use super-fast UFS 3.0 storage, if we really get into it and test the speeds, Samsung's storage is even faster, and the Note benefits from 12GB of RAM versus OnePlus's 8. That said, the overall speed award does still go to the OnePlus. In about 70% of scenarios, it is on top. Third for OnePlus is software, and by this I don't really mean the software skins themselves. I actually really like both Samsung's One UI and OnePlus's Oxygen OS. The more important difference, I think, is in terms of Android versions. The OnePlus 7T Pro ships with Android 10, whilst the Note will probably get it in the next couple of months. But just historically, the OnePlus will probably get future updates faster and will be more likely to get these updates for longer. And finally, probably the biggest factor is price. I'm gonna drop the final prices in a pinned comment below when I get them, but the OnePlus 7T Pro is a cheaper phone, and it's not even close. We've established Samsung ticks more boxes in terms of features, but with this price difference, the real question becomes, are you missing anything significant if you just saved your money and went with the 7T Pro? Kind of. I would say that Samsung's camera is far ahead enough that the difference is significant, but the fact that OnePlus's camera is still really good, and the fact that this phone has a whole lot of other significant perks of its own, makes me say actually, for the majority of users, the 7T Pro is the one I'd be recommending. If price was no object, it would be really, really close, but I would personally side with the Note. If you enjoyed this video, then feel free to check out the ultimate iPhone comparison, which I've been working on for the entire week prior. I'll link that from here. And with that being said, my name is Aaron, this is Mr. Who's the Boss, and I will catch you in the next one.